and whatnot as well. Kanata's here and ready. And so is Sojung. So let's have that interview.
Yep, it was a back and forth match, of course. And let's talk to our MVP tonight with Kanata.
네, 안녕하세요. 고인규입니다. 자, 오늘의 MVP.
Who do you think our MVP will be tonight?
I have no idea. I can't even pick.
Let's see. And it is.
Really?
Yes. I'm just kidding. I mean, like, he won both games.
Well, he's now, I think, tied with Innovation for most wins, right?
Yes.
That's what they've mentioned.
Yeah, he has four wins now.
And he thought that he was going to give up on the most winning rank because he lost last week. But, you know, he took two wins in a row, so I think he wants that title right now.
Yeah, players who play in ace matches always have that extra advantage of playing more games.
Well, my goal is to lose only once per round right now. That's really cool. You know, Byung has grown a lot. You know, he's really the best Terran at Pro League, I think. And now I think CJ will use Byung for every matches. So we don't know, but we'll see.
제가 했을 때는 이 정도는 아니었는데 굉장히 많이 성장을 했습니다.
Well, Kanata is pointing out that Byung wasn't this big when he was a pro, but now he's all grown up.
좋으시죠?
Well, he says he's happy right now. Let's see that recap.
Okay, awesome. We're actually going to look at the first game, which is much better to look at than the last one. So you can see just how much Hellions really do here to the Marines.
Yeah, look at that control. He says he was really confident, you know. It was a really easy control, and he saw a Marine King build, and it was kind of weird. So it wasn't a Hellion build, and he thought he could just move in with his And he saw the tech lab having the Stimpak upgrade, so I think he was really confident about it. And he thinks the Marine King's decision was really bad. Wasn't really that good, that's what he said.
Oh, I'm kind of sad to hear that he feels that way, but I love hearing like that his decision was like that quick. He's like, oh, you're getting stim, and this is a weird build, and I'm just going to punish you for it. The whole, oh, he's doing something weird, let's go kill him kind of old edict.
Well, I think he actually learned a lot from that match against Bravo when he lost, and I think this is the timing when he thought that he won. You know, definitely won this game. And he says against Bravo, he didn't think about the front side when he was going against him, but against Marine King, he definitely studied a lot, learned a lot. And when we watch Byung's games, he likes to protect, and he just goes for that mechanic build, right? And everyone wants to know, why do you just go with the mechanic build? Well, he's just pointing out that he's doing, trying to do bionic builds, but you know, all you can see is the mechanic units right now on the map.
He's like, those are Marines there too.
Well, he says he's really good at bionic also.
Well, he definitely is. He's shown us that before. Of course, this is the second game where he just takes control. If you get two Siege Tanks control on the ramp, the game usually ends.
Well, he says he actually prepared for three things. You know, he thought that Marine King would go for the Double Reaper in the beginning. And he was actually prepared for this, running the game, you know, strongly harassing Marine King in the beginning of the game. Well, he thought that he didn't win completely, but after seeing the situation, he was really confident.
No problem with these Banshees just being total heroes.
He's asking about the controls, if he was intended that mistake. You know, he says that his hands were frozen, so he kind of made some mistakes there, but he still won. I think that's really important, and that pretty much wrapped up the match. So, versus Marine King at 7-1 with Byung. Well,
that's pretty incredible.
6-1 or 7-1, I think it's still really a big gap there. He's asking why Hero hasn't been showing up for ace matches. Well, he's saying that the maps aren't really good for process, as Brendan mentioned earlier. I think he wants that ace match title.
그렇잖아요.
For CJ.
아, 진짜 다음 다음에
The ace card for CJ.
개인리그에서.
네, 아, 네. And he says he doesn't want to meet Hero as individual league because he always loses against Hero as all of you know. And now let's hope that he becomes the definite ace card for CJ Antus.
거기에 대해서 한 말씀해 주시죠.
오늘 뜻밖의 이승을 해서 이렇게 다승한
Well, I didn't expect this two wins and I'm back in the race for most wins for Pro League and I'll just try my best again and show you better games. So this was Byung and Kanata and Sojong.
Thank you as always Sojong for that translation. Well, that was you know really interesting to hear. I really wanted to see Marine King's build get fleshed out because it was unique, it was different. He rushed a stim, and Ben was basically just like, "I think this build sucks. I killed him," which makes me sad because I really wanted to see how that would have worked. I wonder if I was hoping Ben was gonna be like, "Oh, I've seen this before, and I know exactly what to do," and you know, it was really scary because it's a build that can definitely work, but. Was definitely interesting to hear from him regardless. Our next matchup today is going to be KT versus Samsung.
Yeah, and going right into the first match, we got Zest versus Deadwing. Whoa, man.
Well,
that's going to be a hard matchup, man.
That does feel that way sometimes when you play PBZs on that map, but especially for me, man, on the ladder is like my least favorite map to play cross-spawn PBZ on. I hate late-game PBZ, but yeah, this matchup is going to be interesting. You know, Action actually having an upwards arrow. Not so sure about that one.
Well, he is 5-0 in the last five Pro League games, so I feel like that's why he gets that upwards arrow.
Yeah, you know, we have our old guy who did the indicator arrows. Like, he's actually currently in the military, so we have a new guy, and I guess they have, like, different opinions on how they based it.
They definitely do.
So
yes, they do.
Definitely something that we'll be, like, looking at a little bit later, because I know a ton of people have been asking me. I get the tweets about this all the time. Who decides the arrows? I'm like, it's not me, I swear. But yeah, it looks like it's mostly based on their most recent Pro League results. But guys, we've only got a 10-minute break before we go into that second match, KT versus Samsung. So take a quick break, go get a snack or something, but we'll be right back.